Our next guest has been on the show a number of times before, and unless you've been living under a rock, you know exactly who she is. Matter of fact, just ask any Muslim. Every Muslim seems to know who she is. She's the author of the new book, Fatwa, Hunted in America. She's also the publisher of the Geller Report, president of the American Freedom Defense Initiative, and the Stop Islamization of America, Pamela Geller. Welcome back to the show. How are you doing?
Hey, thanks for having me. I'm alive, so all is well.
All is well. So, but that's no laughing matter. I mean, you are somebody who is literally being hunted down.
Yeah, this is why I wrote the book. I think most Americans are painfully unaware that an American in 21st century America is literally living under a 24-hour death threat, the target of multiple Islamic plots to kill me. I mean, just last week, for example, in Boston, the ringleader of an Islamic plot to behead me was convicted on all counts and faces a life sentence. I do think that Americans are painfully, woefully unaware of the threats that we face. The media, academia, we see over and over again, they scrub, they censor, they whitewash, they self-enforce the Sharia. They will not criticize Islam. They will not show Muhammad. This is the Sharia. And I refuse. I refuse to live under it. I'm an American. I love my First Amendment rights. I love my Second Amendment rights. I will not give them up. I will not be pressured to give them up. I will not be bullied into giving them up. Those of us that stand in defense of freedom are ridiculed, mocked, smeared, defamed, libel. And so this book tells my story of how a New York City career girl who loved her art, music, fashion, books, literature, went from being apolitical, and then 9/11 happened, to being the country's most notorious, quote, racist, Islamophobic, anti-Muslim bigot. And that's what they do. They make a monster out of you so that no one will listen to your message. And that's why I wrote the book, and that's why I urge your listeners to get this book. It's the book that they do not want you to read. It's the book they do not want you to see. It's the book that bookstores won't carry. The New York Times won't review it.
What?
Yeah. This is what we're living under. Look, let's look at Vegas for a second. What happened in Vegas was incredibly, I mean, it's unspeakable. There's no word for the monstrosity, the barbarity. And we know that ISIS took credit for it. We also know that ISIS does not take credit for events that are not theirs. Now, I'll tell you right off, I don't know what happened. I can tell you that. I've never seen ISIS double and triple down like that before, saying he converted 6 months ago, giving his Islamic name. But I do know for the FBI to dismiss it out of hand like that is reckless, dangerous, and doing a great disservice to the American people. Look, they were at Garland. I held a free speech event in Garland, Texas, which was attacked by two jihadists who drove 1,000 miles from Arizona to open fire on our event. And the FBI, we know now, was in on the plotting, you know, in on the planning. We know from the text between the FBI agent and Eric Jamal Hendricks in the indictment when he was arrested for recruiting for ISIS. We found out that the FBI was in on the plotting. I didn't have a problem with that, like the left did. Oh, you see, it's entrapment, the left said. Nonsense. You need to embed with these jihad cells in America to find out about the plot. I didn't have a problem with that, like Donnie Brasco, for example, with the mafia, right? My problem was they were at the event. They were texting with the jihadists how many people were there, how many police were there, was there FBI there. They were in the car behind the jihadis. They got out of the car. When the jihadis stopped their car, they took cell phone footage. And when the jihadists began firing on us, the FBI got back in the car and drove away and was actually pulled over by local law enforcement because local law enforcement thought that the FBI was part of the plot. The FBI did not warn us. Yeah, the 60 Minutes did a piece on this, so this is not some conspiracy theory. This is fact. What bothered me was that they didn't have anybody there to protect us. They didn't have anyone there. I mean, it was my SWAT team. It was my security apparatus that took out those jihadis. And so we see this again, even in Boston, this beheading plot. We find out last week during the trial that the FBI was in on this plot. They didn't warn me. The FBI, I mean, leadership, I'm not talking about FBI agents. There are very good FBI agents, but I believe that the top tier has been compromised and infiltrated by these operatives tied to Muslim Brotherhood groups like Council of American Islamic Relations, that they will not, you know, pursue certain investigations because they don't want to appear Islamophobic or racist, even though Islam is not a race. Look at the shooting in Orlando. You had Omar Mateen opening fire at a nightclub and mowing down nightclub revelers, calling 911 during his jihad attack, pledging allegiance to the Islamic State. And 10 months later, the FBI says they don't know the motive behind that attack.
Oh, right.
That should deeply disturb every American. That's why this book is required reading, because it tells you the story of how the ordinary American, like me, and honestly, I'm but a proxy in this terrible long war. What has happened to me is what happens in small and large ways to every American who stands for freedom. So you need to read this book about the fights and the victories. For example, you know, I led the opposition to the Ground Zero Mosque, a 16-story mosquestrosity in a building that was destroyed in the 9/11 attacks. They did not build it. So there are good stories, but also there are stories that should concern every American of freedom of speech, whether, you know, I have filed lawsuits in every major city who denied us the ability to run our ads in response to either pro-jihad ads or anti-Jewish ads, anti-Israel ads. This is a story that America knows nothing about. And so it should be required reading. And honestly, it's an act of defiance. I mean, if you want to show that you will not submit to the Sharia, buy this book and walk down the street with it, because it will piss off care. Yeah, it's an act of defiance. It's a stand in defense of freedom.
So if the FBI knew about the plot, they followed the guys to the plot, they set up the plot, they're taking video of the plot, they get back in their car once the shooting happens instead of helping you, then the FBI tried to kill you, Pam.
Yeah. I mean, what other conclusion can you draw? They wanted something bad to happen to us. Now, listen, at the time, you had a president, President Obama, who got up before the world 1 week after Benghazi and said, the future does not belong to those who slander the prophet of Islam. Now, that's a quote from a Muslim leader in a Muslim country. That's what the Ayatollah Khomeini says. So maybe it was from the top down that gave the stand-down order in Garland, Texas. You know, the thinking being, if something happens to us, it would have a chilling effect, a blood-chilling effect on the freedom of speech. It had it anyway, because the media outlets blamed me. You know, they said I shouldn't have held an art exhibit showing, and what that was, by the way, was an art exhibit showing depictions of Muhammad over the past 1,000 years, showing that people were not always being killed, but they're being killed now to impose the Sharia by violent means across the West.
Well, Pamela, we're up against a break. That's a great place to pause, because, yes, the media did say it was actually your fault for picking the fight, and we'll get to that on the other side. Don't go anywhere, folks.